How you folks doing?
I got a treat for you. What I have created is a visual representation, one of life's biggest aspects. Behold.
What can I get you?
I just have a couple of questions.
Questions? What about?
So, my name is Erica Martinez, and I'm the host for a podcast called My Neighbor is Missing.
Podcast?
Yes. And I'm sure you're aware of this disappearances and missing persons cases here over the years.
Am I ever?
So, I just wanted to ask you and some of the locals how this has affected your community. Also, is it okay if I record this?
No, you can't record this.
How about I write it down?
No interviews. I told you. All this is bad press. We got kids in the parking lot getting shot. Girls running off with their boyfriends. Absolutely not.
I said no.
Just get lost. Anyways.
Hey. Come here. Have a seat. I got a story for you.
You have a story for me?
Oh, yes. I got a story, all right.
What is it?
This town has a rap sheet longer than the Mississippi River. Let me ask you something. You ever been to the woods?
No.
There's bodies in them woods. In the park, there are bodies that have been in their final resting place for nearly 100 years. Bodies as old as my great-grandpa. The bodies as old as you. Bodies as old as Little Miss Muffet.
You've been a big help, but I gotta go.
Pertaining to today's chapter of My Neighbor is Missing. The townspeople made it clear that they're not happy with their town's reputation. There's just something about this town that attracts evil.
And I intend to find out what it is.
Thank you.
I was tipped off that the local park might be a burial ground. So far, I found no signs of burials or graves.
Perhaps I shouldn't rule out the possibility.
I thought I said no interviews. Do you people need to take a hint?
Sorry, I'm not here to record you this time. But I need to ask, who was that man from last night?
Why do you care? It's just some guy that comes in, sits quietly. Every once in a while, we'll talk about, you know, weird stuff.
Do you know anything about him?
It's just some drunk. He's got an arrest record. Why do you care?
Has he been arrested before?
It's quite a sob story, actually. He complained about getting in trouble once or twice for his artwork, whatever that means. You gonna have something to drink?
Well, I guess I have a vodka soda.
There you go.
There's something about this town, and I can't quite put my finger on it. It's eating away at me. The town's history is like a dark cloud that hangs over it and its inhabitants. Haunting this town. In a new lead turned up that I will investigate tomorrow. Tune in to My Neighbor's Missing as I just might crack the code. What the hell happened here?
To see you here.
You?
Yes, me.
Who are you?
I'm the new darkroom technician. What are you doing here? I didn't see you on the schedule.
I'm here to pick up my prints. I left them here a few weeks ago.
You left prints here that long ago? That's funny. I wasn't aware you've been here before. I would have seen you here if you had an account with us.
It had to be before you started working here.
Perhaps. There was a technician that trained me before they quit. Maybe they kept your file.
Yeah, that's probably what happened.
Right. What was their name, that technician? I forget.
I think it was Sam.
Sam? The technician's name was Sam?
Yeah.
Right.
So, are my prints finished?
I imagine they are, since you left them here for that long. What were your pictures of? Maybe we can check the back and find them.
Oh.
You and I.
That's okay. I mean, they've been here so long, it might take you a while to find them. I better get going.
Oh, no. insist. It's no trouble at all.
It's okay. I'm on a test schedule.
Don't go anywhere. I'll find them for you. Sorry I had to lock you in here.
I'm kind of in a rush.
I'm afraid I couldn't find your photos. Why don't you come back another time? Maybe I'll have them ready for you. But please, make sure to call ahead next time.
I have a reason to suspect that I'm being watched. I think my presence has struck a chord with the evil that lurks within the town. Am I getting close? Maybe too close. But that also means that I must dig deeper. The truth cannot be much further. What I have created is a visual representation, one of life's biggest aspects. Behold, the human condition, as grotesque and cruel as it is.
What about these photos portrays the human condition?
Glad you asked. You see these eyes? That's fear. Fear is an emotion that I've studied for over a year. And what I've learned is that fear, response to experiencing something new, yet unorthodox. And what these actors had in common is that they were experiencing bondage.
No!
first time.
You're a fighter, you know that?
It's rare. These images captured a key moment for these people. A moment that will stick with them until they shuffle off this mortal coil.
I had to rough you up more than I'd like. Hold still for me, would you?
What's today's date? Can you tell me? That's what speaks to the human condition. Thank you.